In this video, we will discuss how we can delete a node from the front end of singly linked list. Various cases needs to be considered. There are cases where list is empty. There are cases where list is existing, that is non-empty. Where are the cases where all these cases needs to be dealt separately. Let us see case 1 where list is empty. Here, when list is empty, no node is available in the linked list. Hence, we cannot delete. So we cannot delete a node. So we check whether list is empty by putting a condition whether first is equal to null, is equal to null. If that is the case, the linked list is empty and we'll print appropriate message that linked list is empty and return the pointer. In case 2, list is exist, that is, you have a linked list which consists of 4 nodes, each node like 50, 40, 30 and 20. Now the question is, how can we delete this node at the front end? This is the front end and this is the rear end. So how can we delete this? That is the question. In order to do this, to delete this, we need to follow step A. What is it? We need to have one pointer which is assigned to the first, so that the current would be here. The next step, what we need to do is, we need to either move this over here or this over here, whichever pointer we need to move, we can do it. So we will consider moving this pointer over here. So now if I just say first is equal to first link, now the first would be here. So this one is up moving one pointer to next node. So now we can now current is pointing to this first node. Now here we can print the content and use a function which is free, a function which is to deallocate the memory. So the steps to be followed is very, I'll repeat. You assign one pointer to the first node, then main update or jump the first or either one, we are considering first, to update points to the second node, then we can print this one, or we can, after printing, we can free this. So this is a function and this is a pointer argument. So we can use this function in order to deallocate the memory. So these are the steps that we follow in order to delete a node from the front end. Let us write the equivalent code So we write a node which is delete underscore friend, and which takes one argument, that is a linked list, and it returns upon new linked list, updated linked list. We need a pointer current, and this is the first case where linked list is empty. As we discussed earlier, which we need to check whether first is equal to null, and if it is so, printf list is empty, we print and return the first. Else we follow the case 2, where we as steps, this is the A step and this is B step, where current is pointed to by another, first is pointed by another pointer. Now first is now moved to the next node. Now here we can print the deleted node is this current info. Once it is printed, we can free the first node and return first pointer. So this is the case 2, and that is case 1. These are the steps A, B and free. Then this is end of the function. So this is delete case 1 and case 2. Next we will move on to delete a node from the rear end of singly linked list. There are several cases we need to consider. Case 1, when list is empty, what to do? Case 2, only one node is exist, how to delete that one node? And case 3 is, if more than one node exists, that means more than like 2 or 3 or 4 in the linked list, how to delete from the rear end. For case 1, it is very simple, where we need to compare if the first is equal to null, then we need to display the appropriate message, where we cannot delete a node. Display appropriate message and we cannot delete. That's the next case 2 is only one node is present. Visually we can say like this is only one node present in the linked list. What to do and how to delete this? In this case, how we can know that only one node is present? This can be done using just checking whether if this condition is true, that is if first link is equal to null, if that is the case, then only one node is present. So we'll check whether the first link is equal to null. If this is true, then we'll print the item is deleted like first info, and we'll free this and return null. Case 3 is if more than one node is present. Example, now this is the linked list which consists of four elements. Now deleting a node at the rear end is this one. So we need to delete the end, this particular node. Now to delete this one, we need address of this guy so that we can remove the content over here. We have to remove this content over here because the content is the address of this one. We need to remove the content. Then we can free this. So we need to have the address of this guy and address of this one. So how to get that? The answer is we need to traverse from here using two-pointer method, as we discussed earlier videos. We traverse it, after that we delete it. So the step that we need to follow is as shown here. So, as take this for example, we need, following the steps over here, we need to traverse using two-pointer method and get at the position as shown here. That is, the elements, we need to delete this one, the rear end, but we need the previous address node, node of the previous address. Address of the previous node. So the earlier code as shown over here will be bring the pointers as shown over here. Now we can delete the last node. How we can do it? So these are the steps that we need to follow. Now prevlink, it can be made as assigned null, so that this happens, thus this link is cut now. This is null, and now this, there is no link at all between prev and current. Now then we can print current info as deleted item. Then we can free the current. Then return first. So this is what the logic of case 3, where we have to traverse and come to this, get the node, address of the node, and the previous address of the node. Once we get, we can remove using this statement, where we write a null, update null, and then we can print appropriate message and free the last node. We will write now our function delete rear, which accepts a linked list and it returns a linked list pointer to a linked list. We need two pointers, that is current and previous. This is the first case where list is empty, where for that we cannot delete a node where the list is empty. That is the first case. So this is the code for handling the first case. This is the second case where only one node is present. We check whether first link is equal to null. If this is the case, then we will just print the content, the first info, as a deleted item, then we free that particular memory locations, then return null. So this is case 2, where only one node is present, and this is how we will delete a node which is present in the linked list. Now the case 3, we had two steps. One is traversing, and this, the code is full is depicted like traversing. How we can traverse? A little bit change over done over here, where we use link which is not equal to null. earlier traversing, we had like current is not equal to null. That's the only difference here, traversing, which will leave, which will, now here we will have address of two nodes. One address is the last node address and the previous node address. So we are writing, updating previous node to null, then deleted item is now here current info. Then we need to free the current, then return the first. So this is close of else, close of function. So this is case 3, where two steps, one is delete the rear, step 1 traverse, we will be in the position where current will be pointing to the last node and previous is pointing to the previous last but one node. So we can delete using this function a node from the rear end. As we have finished the application, finished several operations on singly linked list, such as insertion rear and front end, deletion rear and front end, and display the contents of singly linked list. Now we move on how these operations or singly linked list can be used in order to implement stack operations. As shown over here, as we know that stack operations are push, where a element is pushed in the stack, pop, where a element is deleted, and display, variety of configuration can be done. Now display the top of the stack or whole content of the stack. So we can do both of this. We'll consider displaying whole content of the stack itself, that is equivalent to displaying whole content of the linked list. What is the equivalent operation of linked list, which is equivalent to pop, and what is the equivalent operation of the linked list, which is equivalent to push? In order to find the answer for that question, we need just revise once again what is the stack operation and how it is done. As we know that the stack operation is first in, first out, or last in, last out. First in, first out, or last in, or last out. Otherwise, we can say otherwise, in the stack, there is only one end. Only one end through which elements are pushed and elements are popped. With this analogy, with this stack analogy, I'll just apply this is the stack and this is the end, open end. And one here it is closed. Now the dashed line shows the stack, and this is one element and this is another element, this is another element, like this. So there is one end where elements are pushed and elements are pushed and elements are popped. So now same over here, if we consider the linked list, which is the operation that we can implement, we can use in order to demonstrate stack operation using linked list. Now this pop is equivalent to delete front, and this push is equivalent to insert front. Look at that, same end is we have used. So insert front and delete front and display of the linked list, if these three operations that we write and create linked list, these three operations can be made or implements stack operation. Similarly, if you consider a linked list where this is end is closed, and now here this one is open. Now which is the in now you can see that push and pop happens at the same end. Now which is the implementation where now you can see that this is the front end of this linked list and this is the rear end of the linked list, where we need to pop means delete rear, and over here push means insert rear. Now you can observe that same end is we can delete and we can insert. Now display, if we add these three, implement these three in a program or in a code, then we implement stack operation using linked list. I hope this is clear enough, where linked list can also used in order to implement stack operation. I just conclude the application of stack. If we implement push, pop and display, we can use array in order to implement stack operation. Now here we are using linked list to implement the stack. Now in the linked list operation, if we use insert rear, delete rear and display, that is linked list at the same end, linked list operation where we insert and delete at the rear end is also a stack operation, stack implementation using linked list. Now another configuration where insert front and delete front and display, then also we are implementing stack operation using linked list. So we can have two configuration in order to implement stack operations. Using linked list. Now you can use singly linked. We can discuss now another application of linked list, in which we can implement a queue using linked list. The operations of linked list is inserting an element at the rear end or deleting an element at the front end. We can observe that elements are inserted at one end and deleted at another end. You can visualize an array of elements inserting at the rear end or deleting at the front end as shown here, or the other way, where this would be the front end and this would be the rear end, the flipped array. And if we implement a display, then that is implementation of queue. How these queue implementation can be simulated using linked list operation. The observation that we have to make is inserting at the rear end happens and at front end. Now using linked list operations such as insert, using linked list operation insert rear and delete front, if we implement, then we are implementing queue using linked list. So that is what we can say about the operations of our application of linked list implementation of queue. We can conclude like this: if insertion at different ends, then this is implementation of queue. Delete rear or delete front, this is also queue because different ends are there. Now if you come like this, then it is stack implementation. This is also stack implementation, and this is queue implementation. So if you use insert rear and insert front, then it is queue implementation. Delete rear and delete front, it is also queue implementation. If you use like this at the same, like insert rear and delete rear and display, it is a stack implementation. Insert front, delete front and display, it is also a stack implementation.